Hello everyone, this is Rajkumar Singh. Welcome back to my series of lectures on quantum mechanics. Today we will have lecture on WKB approximation. I have divided this lecture in four parts. We are having the first part here. In the first part, we will have detailed discussion on how the theoretical foundation of this approximation takes place. And gradually we will shift to the second part, third part and the fourth part, and going through the other details of this approximation. So in this particular video lecture, we will have a theoretical foundation of the WKB approximation. ये जो WKB है, this stands for Wenzel, Cramer and Brillouin, जो लोगों ने independently इस पर work करते हुए 1926 पर WKB approximation को develop किया था. हालांकि ऐसा मानना है कि इनके पहले मैथमेटिशियन जेफरी ने इसको 1923 में डेवलप किया था. एनीवे, डब्ल्यूकेबी मेथड से हम लोग क्या कर सकते हैं? वी कैन ऑब्टेन अप्रोक्सीमेट सॉल्यूशन टू द टाइम डिपेंडेंस श्रोडिंगर इक्वेशन इन वन डायमेंशन, दैट इज द नंबर वन. एंड नंबर टू, वी कैन यूज दिस इन कैलकुलेटिंग टनलिंग रेट्स थ्रू पोटेंशियल बैरियर्स एंड द बाउंड स्टेट एनर्जीज. नाउ वेयर वी कैन अप्लाई इट, इट कैन बी अप्लाइड to a system with slowly varying potentials. Now this is for the first time that we are considering potential depending on certain parameters. Before this, you have studied the quantum mechanical problems involving constant potential compared to the kinetic energy of the particle. Now in the system where potential is not constant, rather it varies with some parameter, however the variation is not that it will go varying to the unlimited extent. Of course there is restriction to what order or how much it can vary. So ye jo variation ka range hai, it is limited up to certain order of de Broglie wavelength. Therefore, and that is why also this method is also known as semi-classical approximation. Let's see how it works. For this we have to consider a motion of a particle in a time independent potential Vr. And as usual, the Schrodinger equation for the stationary state will be minus h cross square del square by 2m plus Vr, operating on the wave function psi r, and that is equal to E psi r. And we solve it to the next stage, we get del square psi r plus 1 by h cross square, within bracket we have 2m E minus Vr psi r equal to 0, and the for the bracket term we take it as p square r, where this p stands for the classical momentum at position r, and it is given by square root of 2m e minus vr. So now we have relative cases of between comparison between e and vr. So there are three possibilities. First is that when e is less than vr. Second possibility is that e is greater than vr. And third possibility, which comes here for the first time as you move on from your graduation syllabus, when E equal to VR. And of course, there is one restriction and one possibility with VR as well. Before we have a study that VR remains constant to a particular value V naught. But now in this approximation, VR will keep on changing with a given parameter. We'll see in this particular discussion. So in first case, when the potential is constant and energy E of the particle is greater than V, then this is the case when the incident particle is having kinetic energy more than the given potential. So the wave function takes the form psi r equal to A exponential plus minus I P dot r by h cross, where these plus and minus signs have been used for particles traveling to the left and to the right and the left respectively. And the general solution is the linear superposition of the two. And here one point to be noted is that the wavelength associated is lambda equal to 2 pi by p, and that is 2 pi by square root of 2m e minus vr. And the wave function is oscillatory with fixed amplitude a. Now consider the case when vr is not constant. वैसे केस को कंसीडर करेंगे अभी हम लोग, जिसमें पोटेंशियल कांस्टेंट नहीं होगा बल्कि इट विल वेरी ओवर सर्टेन रेंज ऑफ डी ब्रॉग वेवलेंथ गिवन बाय लैम्डा इक्वल्स टू 2 पाई बाय पी. नाउ इन सच case is, what happens, wave functions will remain sinusoidal, but both the amplitude and wavelength will change with R. That means we will have rapid oscillations modulated by gradual change in amplitude and wavelength. Now let us consider the other case, when potential is constant, but energy of the particle is less than the potential. In this case, the particle wave function has the form psi r equal to a exponential plus minus p dash dot r by h cross. यहाँ पर ध्यान देने की चीज है कि यहाँ पर exponential में i factor नहीं है. And this p dash is itself imaginary and is equal to i times p r, that is equal to root over 2m v r minus e this time. इस केस में भी wave function sinusoidal है, लेकिन amplitude और wavelength दोनों change होंगे with respect to r. So this way we have seen this particular case. Now वो समय आ गया है जब हम लोग उस special case को deal करें, जिस वक्त e will be equal to v. That is, in this v r is not slowly varying with lambda. So since this lambda is 2 pi by root of, on the denominator we have the momentum, and in this particular case the momentum vanishes, because in the root under sign e minus v r will be zero. So ये वो particular case है जिस केस में momentum vanish करता है और wavelength जो है infinite हो जाता है. So this particular situation is called classical turning point. So the point at which momentum vanishes and wavelength becomes infinite are called the classical turning point, because at this particular point, when the momentum vanishes, you can think of that the particle has its velocity zero, as if it is similar to the case when a stone is thrown upward in the sky, and when it reaches to the highest point, momentarily its velocity becomes zero and then it falls downward. So in this case, classically, particle stops at that point and then turns back to resume its motion in the opposite direction. The wave function we normally use in WKB approximation are often expressed in polar form, just like any complex number z can be written as r exponential I theta, where r and theta are magnitude and phase of z respectively. We can write the time independent wave function in one dimensional psi x in a similar way, psi x equal to root over rho x exponential I sx by h cross, where rho x and sx are real and rho x is not negative. Sx is written in unit of h cross. This sx is a complex number because wave functions are not in general pure phases. The real part of sx divided by h cross is the phase of wave function, and iska jo imaginary part hai, that will determine the magnitude of wave functions. So it can be shown through the calculations of probability density that this rho x becomes 1, and so we have psi x equal to exponential I psi x by h cross. Ab is psi ke expression ko use karenge Schrodinger equation mein time independent form mein. So we go very systematically, minus h cross square d2 by dx square, this is the expression for psi, and on the right hand side we have p square and psi. So we take the first time derivative and then we take derivative of that, and this way very systematically moving ahead we come to the next expression, that is in the next slide, and we have this expression for that, which is written as equation 6. In this equation, we have the term with I h cross s double dash x. This is supposed to be small because as s tends to 0. Now let us take the series expansion of sx with h being a small parameter. So sx equal to s naught s plus h cross s1 plus h cross square s2x and so on. जहाँ पर s naught x का unit h cross होगा, क्योंकि sx को h cross के unit में लिखा गया है, तो s naught x का unit हो गया h cross. h cross s1, इसलिए s1 का कोई यूनिट नहीं होगा, और h cross स्क्वायर s2x है, तो s2 का जो यूनिट होगा 1 by h cross के टर्म्स में होगा. इस इक्वेशन 7 को यूज करते हैं इक्वेशन 6 में, विच इज ऑन द टॉप ऑफ दिस स्लाइड. देन वी हैव दिस एक्सप्रेशन एट द एंड ऑफ दिस स्लाइड, एंड कीप ऑन सॉल्विंग दिस एंड अरेंजिंग द टर्म विच आर फ्री विथ h cross एंड द वन विच आर विथ h cross. वी हैव these two expressions. इस एक्सप्रेशन में दो टर्म है, एक वो है जिसमें एच क्रॉस नहीं है और दूसरे में एच क्रॉस है। दोनों को बारी बारी इक्वेट टू जीरो करते हैं तो फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट टर्म इटसेल्फ वी गेट दिस एक्सप्रेशन इक्वल टू जीरो, और जिसको सॉल्व करने से मिलता है एस नॉट एक्स इक्वल टू प्लस माइनस इंटीग्रल एक्स नॉट टू एक्स पी एक्स डैश डी एक्स डैश इक्वेशन 11। और उसी प्रकार से जब सेकेंड ब्रैकेट टर्म को इक्वेट टू जीरो करते हैं फ्रॉम देयर वी गेट एक्सप्रेशन फॉर एस वन डैश इक्वल टू आई बाई टू एस नॉट डबल डैश बाई एस वन डैश, और इस प्रकार से फाइनली वी हैव एन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर एस वन। नाउ यूजिंग दिस वैल्यू ऑफ एस नॉट एंड एस वन इन द सीरीज एक्सपेंशन पार्ट ऑफ एस एक्स वी हैव द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर वेव फंक्शन साई एक्स इक्वल टू एक्सपोनेंशियल आई बाई एच क्रॉस एंड इन प्लेस ऑफ एस एक्स वी हैव दिस एक्सप्रेशन एस नॉट एक्स प्लस एच क्रॉस एच वन एंड सो ऑन। यहाँ से दो एक्सपोनेंशियल टर्म बनता है एक्सपोनेंशियल आई बाई एच क्रॉस एस नॉट एक्स एंड द अदर वन इज एक्सपोनेंशियल आई एस वन एक्स। नाउ साई के इस एक्सप्रेशन में एस नॉट एक्स और एस वन एक्स को यूज करते हैं सो वी हैव दिस एक्सप्रेशन दिस इज कमिंग फ्रॉम एस नॉट एक्स एंड दिस इज कमिंग फ्रॉम एस वन एक्स फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस स्लाइड। इफ यू केयरफुली सॉल्व द सेकेंड टर्म दिस सिंप्लीफाइज टू ए बाई रूट ओवर पी एक्स बाई जस्ट एज्यूमिंग दैट दिस ब्रैकेट टर्म इक्वल्स टू लॉग ए and then arranging the terms in the log product form log mn equal to these two and this way we will get that this exponential turns out to be a by root over px. Using this back into the equation 13 we get expression for psi x that is in this form, and this is basically the basic solution of WKB approximation. The amplitude of this wave is proportional to 1 by root over px, that is 1 by root over momentum. Hence, the probability of finding the particle between x and x plus dx is also proportional to this. Or, ye classically expected bhi hai because the time taken by a particle to travel a distance dx is proportional to inverse of its speed or its momentum. Now let's write the general solution for the allowed and forbidden reason from this basic solution. Allowed reason, wo reason hai jisme e greater than vx hoga, so momentum will be positive, and we have this expression for wave function psi x in this two term, combination of two terms where the first term and the second terms are respectively for the right side going wave and the left side going wave. And in the forbidden reason, this happens when E is less than Vx. So, in this case, momentum is imaginary. It is written in terms of IKx, where Kx is positive, real. The general solution here again consists of two parts. One is for the right side going wave, and the other one is for the left side going wave, with the only difference that in the integral sign, we don't have I, which we have in the case in the allowed reason when E is greater than V. So this way we have seen the solution of the wave in the two reasons. Now in the next lecture we will consider the condition under which WKB approximation is valid, and we will consider three independent cases and apply this approximation to find out the energy states and the solution for the wave function. And our considerations will be limited to bound states for potential wells with no residuals, bound states for potential wells with one residuals, and finally bound states for potential wells with two residuals. With this, we come to conclusion of our today's lecture on WKB approximation. This is the first lecture in this series. Please keep watching the next lectures, and we have three more lectures in this series labeled as part 2, part 3 and part 4. Thank you so much for watching this.